Hi friends, I just got back from the Dollar Tree. I went to go get just a few more little Valentine-y things. I'm going to be sending off a box to my cousin for his three girls. I had bought them a few little, just some pajamas and cute little outfits and stuff because I had missed their birthdays, which were just right before Christmas. And so I just wanted to send them some cute little Valentine outfits. And oops, sorry about that sound. And I wanted to include some like little color books or crayons or something with it. So I went ahead and went to Dollar Tree. Of course, I picked up a few more little Valentine things. But I also bought this plastic container. And I need it because I am leaving today to go to Denver for a few days to go see the grandchildren. And guys, I don't want to leave my crafting stuff behind. I'm going to be thinking rosettes and banners and stamps and all that while I'm gone. So I decided that I was going to try to put together just a little container like this. I went online, I went on scrapbook.com, and I went to Hobby Lobby a couple of days ago looking for a container. And I know that there's those nice, I guess, Iris brand containers, but I just do not want to spend that right now. And I just can't with some other things that I really want and need and, you know, all of that kind of thing. So I just bought this dollar container and I'm going to see what I can put in it. I think that, I was hoping that this would fit in there. This is a, Nope, it's not going to fit. I was hoping that this small Fiskars paper cutter would fit in there and then I could bring that. So, you know what? I think I'm just going to put that in a Ziploc baggie. I just don't want it to break, but I'm going to put that in a Ziploc baggie and I'm going to bring that separately. So I have this small score and obviously that's not going to fit in there either. So, you know what? I am going to put these two things together in a Ziploc baggie and then I will just bring that separately. So let's see what I'm going to bring. It's not going to be just all about Valentine's because I just want to make some things that I can use. You know, people have in their stash, they pull out, you know, pre-made rosettes and pre-made this and pre-made that. So I bought this fun paper when I was at Hobby Lobby yesterday. It includes it's called Treat Yourself. Many of you probably already have this 6x6 paper, 20 designs, 120 sheets. And so it's just so cute. It's birthday. It looks like celebration and all of that. So I think I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. And then I also have this 6x6 pad of paper from Echo Park, and same thing, 24 double-sided, 65-pound cardstock. On both of these papers are one-sided. Oh, no, wait a minute. This is double-sided. Oh, my gosh, I didn't realize that. Did I get this at Hobby Lobby? Where did I get this? I think I may have got this at Hobby Lobby. So, all right, so I don't have a lot of paper, guys. I'm just still buying paper. And so I have these two, so I'm going to bring that. I'm going to bring my bone folder. And then, let's see, what else am I going to put in here? If I had a smaller circle die cut, then I could bring that, but I don't. And so I have this one. I have the 1-inch, and the 1-inch fits in there. That's good. And then, you know what? I probably want to bring some just plain colored cardstock, just like that, that I could die cut. But I don't have any. I just have these big 12 by 12 pieces. So I'm going to go ahead and cut some down, and then I'll stick those in there as well. Okay, so I just cut some paper. All right, friends, here I am. I'm in Denver now. So let me show you what I've done. This is about 3 days later. And so this is what I brought with me, right? And oops, so here's what I've done. I did this a couple of days ago in between playing with the grandchildren and, you know, just spending time with my son and daughter-in-law. I went ahead and used just some regular I just brought 6x6 paper, right? So I just used some plain cardstock, and I used this small, just 1-inch scallop die cut to die cut some circles that I can use for embellishments, I guess, and whatever else I want to use them for. And then I had, I wanted to try some, using some paper also to use with the scallop die cut. So I did some paper, you can see there. And then, okay, I tried my hand at, I bought all these paper clips at, I think Target, I think, and I tried my hand at like making one of the little, just starting to make the little, what are they called, banners maybe, with paper on a paper clip. I mean, I have, you know, to embellish it up and all that stuff, but I don't know, I have to figure that out and see if this is the right size or if I even like this. I haven't decided yet. Still have, you know, several pieces of cardstock, and I had brought, I think I showed this already, right? I have this paper, and then I have this paper. I kind of wanted to go while we're here in Denver to go and see if I could buy some more paper, but it hasn't happened because, you know, the weather and stuff. But I have made these rosettes, so I just kept it simple. I made small rosettes. These are, let's see, I used 1-inch. I'm pretty sure I just cut 1-inch. Why isn't this coming out? So I just made these and put a little sticker on there, just nice and simple with that scallop. Here's the back of it. This is two-sided paper. Not all of these are two-sided. Well, are they all two-sided paper? Let me see. I think they are. So, you know, you guys are always talking about your stash. I can build up my stash or I can give these away, either way. So this is just one-sided paper, this one. So, I mean, it's cute, but obviously, you know, the back is just one side, whereas these, you have more choice of using whichever side. I like this side too, this black and red paper. And then we went to the grocery store, and in their Valentine's section, they had these stickers. So I went ahead and bought these stickers. I really don't need any stickers, any heart stickers or Valentine stickers, but I went and bought them just because I knew I was going to be making those rosettes, and I wanted to just see about, you know, just adding a little embellishment on there. So yeah, that was fun. So I think tonight I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut some more paper. I think I'm going to make some more rosettes here. And oh guys, guess what? So you saw the glue that I had, the glue bottle in here was 4 ounces. And so, nope, they confiscated it at the airport and wouldn't let me bring it. So I just borrowed my daughter-in-law's glue gun, and that's what I used to make, to glue the rosettes together. Then I bought this at the same grocery store we went to. I bought a pack of 3, and then that's what I used to make these. And I have some little scraps of paper over here. Didn't throw any of that away over there. So anyway, I'm going to cut out some more. I think these are fun. I'm going to cut out some more paper to make some more rosettes tonight. I have to plug in the glue gun. And that's it. So this has been a good little container. Oh, guys, look. This is where I have the glue gun. So put that on. So this has been a good little container to just, you know, if you would just want to make rosettes, if you just want to bring some paper. So this is just a good little starter container to bring. In this separate gallon-sized bag, I have paper cutter and then the small scoreboard in there. So that's one way to travel when you want to craft. Bye, guys. Thanks for stopping by.